The Hong Kong government has announced a $2.4 billion surplus package to boost the city's struggling economy. It comes after Financial Secretary Paul Chan said the city's economic growth forecast for 2019 was likely to be revised to 0 to 1%. That's down from 2 to 3%. Mr. Chan said this was in response to significant downward pressure on the economy, citing external factors like China-US trade tensions and Brexit, and also the ongoing political crisis at home.
近期香港發生的事令我們原本已經疲弱的經濟更加受到重創，環球經濟環境是非常之差的，我們現在面對一個內外交困的形勢，美國和內地的貿易摩擦在8月份再度升溫，主要經濟體的經濟增長都減慢，金融市場大家看到波幅的波動亦都加劇。 英國硬脫歐嗰個風險係好顯著嘅，中東地緣政治嘅緊張局勢咧亦都持續，而亞洲區內咧個工業同埋貿易嘅活動咧亦正在減弱。Our
correspondent Roland Lim joins us now to tell us more. Roland, what are some of the measures covered in the stimulus package?
Yeah, more than 1.4 million taxpayers and low-income households set to benefit. The 2019 budget, if you remember, announced earlier this year to reduce salaries tax, profit tax by 75%, and now will be raised to 100%, but there's still a maximum cap of some $2,600 US. So if you pay more than $2,600 in taxes, we will still have to shell out the difference. All kindergarten, primary, secondary schools will each receive a subsidy of $320 per student. Now, this will cost the government some $300 million. Households also receiving a one-off electricity subsidy of some 2,000 Hong Kong dollars, and more than 2.7 million families will actually stand to benefit from this. And extra month's payments are given to welfare recipients, as well as those receiving old age and disability allowances from the government. Lower income tenants in public housing units, they'll also have their rents waived for 1 month, and that'll cost the government some 1.4 billion Hong Kong. For small and medium-sized enterprises, which accounts for 98% of all businesses here and employs around 45% of the total workforce, the government will be waiving government fees and charges for 12 months in hard-hit sectors like maritime, tourism, retail, as well as catering. And now if businesses actually pay rent to the government as tenants, well, rents there will be halved for 6 months. And the government also setting a moratorium on fees and charges, so no raising of them until the end of 2020. The SME funds will also be receiving further enhancements and financing, and the government also wants to be speeding up minor works and small-scale improvement programs around the city to create more jobs.
Now, Roland, how big a role have the ongoing protests played in pushing the economy downwards?
Yeah, well, Financial Secretary Paul Chan insisted that the package has to do with Hong Kong's economic downturn, not due to political difficulties that the administration is now facing. He cited a host of reasons for these measures. You heard some of them, including a worsening global outlook, the escalating U.S.-China trade tensions, as well as steering clear of using the word protest in his speech, downplaying the current political tensions as what he calls social incidents. Now, these social incidents, he added, has had the effect of adding a further blow to an already weak economy. 29 countries have issued different levels of travel alerts to the city. International credit ratings agencies have also expressed concern. So tourist numbers, as well as businessmen traveling into the city, have fallen. And that's having an impact on retail, restaurants, tourism sectors. That much Mr. Chan did acknowledge. So Mr. Chan, other officials here, very clear in pointing out that these measures announced today were not meant to quell public discontent, but to relieve the burdens on SMEs and the Hong Kong residents. He's hoping that through these measures, that Hong Kong people will actually be able to maintain their confidence in the economy and spend a little more, he says.
All right, many thanks for that update. Roland Lim speaking to us from Hong Kong.